Hey guys, so today I'll be sharing with you all some everyday habits and hacks to get rid of strawberry legs. So just keep watching this video to find out. For starters, make sure you're not using any harsh scrubs because they can really irritate your skin and cause the open hair follicles to darken even further. Instead, use a soft face sponge. I know this doesn't sound like good enough, but trust me, it works really well for cleaning up the skin without causing any damage. Since strawberry legs are essentially a lot of open comedones with trapped oil and dead skin cells, you need to start scrubbing 2 to 3 times a week. For this, I love using the Body Cupid 24K Gold Scrub. Now you can use whatever you want to use, guys. I'm just sharing what I am using because the scrub has very, very tiny particles which very gently scrubs and exfoliates the skin without irritating it further. Apart from scrubbing the skin really well, it also adds a nice glow and a good finish, which is very, very essential because your skin is right now feeling very dull. Once you're done scrubbing, take some tea tree oil, dilute it in water, and make little ice cubes out of it. Then very gently pat these ice cubes on your skin to remove any bacterial infections and close all the pores. Doing this about 2 times a week can go a long way in preventing strawberry legs and also reversing the original problem which you are dying to get rid of. And moisturize your skin using any product which is non-comedogenic, which includes not using coconut oil. Now usually I love using coconut oil and I think it's a great moisturizer, but when you have open pores, it can actually clog the pores further. So use a gentle body butter or any product that works for you and use that to keep your skin moisturized. And to prevent the existing bacterial infection from spreading, well, apple cider vinegar to the rescue once again. You can just add a few drops to your bath water regularly, or even better, like I do, every once in a while you can actually clean your skin with an apple cider vinegar face wash. Now once again, you can use whatever product you want. I'm just sharing what I like using. I love using this face wash, guys, because this face wash comes in a foam form, so it's very, very light, very, very mild on the skin, and it feels really refreshing. Plus it contains apple cider vinegar, so it does the job of all in one. And since we're talking about strawberry legs, guys, how can I not talk about infected hair follicles, which I'm sure we all hate so much. So what are infected hair follicles? When the hair, instead of growing upwards, starts growing downwards or in some other direction, and then there's a pus formation around it, it gets all infected and the pus formation comes off as a white tiny bump on the skin. It's painful, annoying, and looks really, really bad. So here's what you can do. First of all, when you start waxing or epilating, do it slowly, do it patiently, and keep your skin clean and scrubbed at all times. Okay, that's very important. And secondly, when you're using a razor especially, first slather your skin with aloe vera gel because this will really protect your skin and make the process a lot easier. And then using aloe vera gel as your lubricant, take your razor, make sure it is sharp, not blunt. This is very important. And then in smooth movements, shave your skin. So do not use abrupt movements. Do not do this very fast or too slow. Even that's something which you don't want. And use it gently because first of all, you'll not hurt yourself. And secondly, the skin will not peel off. As long as you can ensure all these things, I can guarantee you guys, the strawberry legs as well as the infected hair follicles will reduce and even stop eventually. And if your strawberry legs issue is out of control and hasn't been resolved in a long, long time, you can talk to your doctor. I repeat, talk to your doctor about something called retinoids. Now, retinoids are great for getting rid of dead skin cells and also to some extent about uneven skin tone. Things like that can also be taken care of to some extent. Let me also mention here, very importantly, retinoids are not recommended in certain medical cases for pregnant women and, you know, things like that. So like I said, talk to your doctor, but they can be useful if your doctor gives you the permission. So guys, that's what I wanted to share today. Honestly, strawberry legs can seem like such a big problem. And yes, they are sometimes very, very visible. But honestly, it's a very simple thing. It's open pores getting contaminated by dead skin cells, oil, and all kinds of things. So as long as you can just keep your skin clean, scrubbed, and well moisturized using the right products, you should be good enough and good to go. So guys, if you have any hacks of your own to share for strawberry legs, if you have any DIYs, please share them in the comment section below. I would love to hear from you guys, and the best hacks, the best DIYs will get a thumbs up and a pin up of the comment from me. And if there are multiple good comments, I'll just pin up your comments one by one as I see through them. Let's see how that goes. So yes guys, that's all I want to share. All the products used in today's video, I have shared the details with the links in the description box below. And yep, that's about it. Don't forget to hit like on this video before you leave, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave this channel, and turn on the bell icon for notifications. I'll keep coming back to Superbar Style for more. Thank you so much for watching guys. This is me, Prachi, signing off now.